This Thursday Thought is brought to you by WP Engine, the best way to host your WordPress website so you can sleep well at night. With automated updates and daily backups of your site, you probably won't need their award-winning 24/7 support, but just in case anything comes up, it's there for you. You can go to tpmfocus.com/WP to learn more. And if you decide to sign up, just use the code WPE3FREE. Again, that's WPE as in WordPress Engine 3FREE free. WPE3 free. And you'll get 3 months free using that promo code. Let's take a moment to connect the dots. Every Thursday, in under 10 minutes, I'm going to share with you real-life, everyday situations to help you as an entrepreneur, a leader, an innovator, or just a person who's venturing out to try something new. These stories will help you make sense of situations you may find yourself in and also provide encouragement to keep you moving forward in your journey. I was watching YouTube on my TV and I ran across a video with the famous Oprah Winfrey. And I thought to myself, surely this is a full Oprah production. It can't just be a regular YouTube video. But it was only 4 minutes long. So I was like, okay. And I clicked on it and I saw it was just Oprah sitting in her office and turning on her cell phone to talk to us, like the people, whoever is on YouTube. And at first I thought I'm always in business thinking mode and branding and marketing, you know, and everything has an angle to it once you're in my world. And I first thought, wow, if Oprah can spend time creating content to keep her brand out there, no one else out here is above that. Everyone needs to be doing that, right? If you want to have this impact on the world, because we are all responsible for remaining relevant and in front of those that we're on this planet to help, to serve, to inspire, to provide insight to, or do something that's within our purpose. So I was only 3 minutes into the video, and I think the video was about 3 to 4 minutes long. And lo and behold, Oprah hit on something I had just spoke about earlier that day, and the topic was on boundaries. I was talking about how creating and maintaining your own boundaries is not only critical, but healthy for all parties involved, even though it may not feel like it at first or feel good when you have to enforce those boundaries. But at the end of the day, you're happier, you're more productive, but most importantly, you're more true to yourself. Isn't that what we all want? So who knew that implementing boundaries was the way to get that? I surely didn't until I was so worn out by other people and really by life in general. And by the way, a major sign of having a lack of boundaries is feeling worn out. So earlier that day, I was actually speaking about this book by Henry Cloud and John Townsend, and it's titled Boundaries, When to Say Yes, How to Say No to Take Control of Your Life. Well, online, they describe this book as, and I quote, a classic guide on setting healthy boundaries and finally taking the reins in your own life. Using both Christian faith and contemporary psychology, the authors create a strong argument for why healthy boundaries are essential for your emotional and spiritual health. Just to be clear, you don't have to be of Christian faith or beliefs to really get value from this book. I find that it's for everyone. And for me, the top two lessons that I took from this book are, number one, setting boundaries requires you to take ownership of and prioritize your own needs, wants, and feelings. That is nobody else's responsibility to do that but yours. And it's actually nothing wrong with prioritizing your own needs, wants, and feelings. In fact, many people feel guilty for doing this. But really, setting boundaries is an act of kindness to yourself as well as to everyone around you. Aren't you a better person to the people when you're happier and doing things you want to do and not doing the things you don't want to do? As we all know, after a while of saying yes to things that you really wanted to decline, you become resentful for all people involved, and you even beat yourself up sometimes. So on to point two. The second top lesson I got from this book is, though setting boundaries will greatly improve your quality of life, you actually won't want to do it at first. It'll be hard to do. Setting boundaries is hard to do, especially if you have people around you that are manipulative and or controlling. And we all have people around us with those personality traits somewhere. A lot of times, most times, they're not self-aware of it. And we don't really label it as that either. You know, this person or people could be in your house, in your family, at work, at church. They are somewhere in your life. We all have them. And these are the people where it's actually hardest to set those boundaries for yourself and stick to them. You know why? Because you're part of the problem. You see, their behavior for seeking you out when they need you to do something for them actually makes you feel needed. Hear me out now. Hear me out. This is one of those Thursday thoughts that may not feel good today. But listen, their neediness and your reliance on that feeling of being needed can be addictive. And it turns into this cycle so much that you actually seek out friends who treat you the same way. And the next thing you know, you have a whole network of needy people with no boundaries in place. And even when you do try to put those boundaries in place, you'll even find yourself making excuses for those people who violate your boundaries when you're not yet ready to hold steady and commit to your own boundaries. Yes, the ones you've set in place. When you're not ready to hold steady, that means you're not yet committed to your happiness over other people's. And then you stay in this cycle of feeling needed, then regret and resentment. And who wants to live a life like that? It's certainly not one of genuine happiness. And you'll find yourself being upset and snippy with them when you just should have said no. And all of this takes energy away from what you're really supposed to be doing. So to help you get started on this journey of having healthy boundaries, I have a couple of suggestions for you. The first is take a listen to Oprah's video on boundaries. I've linked it in the show notes and it's also in a transcription. Secondly, I would say, go ahead and get Henry Cloud's book on boundaries. It's even on Audible now, and there's an updated version on Kindle as well. But I must warn you, you're going to be forced to take a good look at yourself while going through this book. Be ready, but I promise you won't regret it.